Let's start at this miter. It's a terrible job. It's uneven. It's open. Water can get in there, ruin the countertop below and the cabinet itself. And look back here. There's a big gap in the wall. A water or debris can get stuck and go down behind the cabinet. This should have been scribed tighter to the wall.
All right, so counter goes.
Right. While we're at it, we might as well replace the sink. I've already disconnected the plumbing and the brackets for the sink, so it should pull right out.
Okay.
Okay, good.
Yep.
All right, let's pick up your end there, Kevin. Pull it right up above the stove. Slide it right over.
It's gonna come out in one piece, looks like.
Watch out for that picture on the wall there.
All right, okay. There we go.
Is that watch out for the ceiling?
Hey, look at that. You can see the damage caused by the water.
Oh yeah, see that miter was leaking. It leaked around the sink. It damaged the countertop. It's all falling apart. What I like to use for the countertop, Kevin, is a plywood. This is an AC plywood.
Meaning we've got one nice smooth side.
Right. It also has an exterior glue, so you don't have to worry about any moisture or steam.
Good for underneath the countertop.
Right. I'll make it tight to that wall. All right. Nice
and tight. Pretty tight here, yep.
Okay. Now, to make the countertop a tight fit against the wall, I could set my scribes a little wider than the gap and follow the wall with my scribes.
And then you could just cut along that line, you'd have a nice tight fit to the wall. So is that what you're gonna do?
Well, I could, but there's a couple of things I need to accommodate for. First of all, I wanna have a quarter of an inch overhang on the cabinet.
So the plywood should come beyond this cabinet side by about a quarter of an inch there.
That's right. Okay. So I lay the countertop back down, and I'm gonna slide it over just about a quarter. Okay, I'd say right about there.
Right there.
Okay, now I have to allow for the thickness of the backsplash because the backsplash is going to go between the wall and the end of the countertop.
And it's just another piece of this 5/8 plywood.
Right. So I take the backsplash, push it tight to the wall, and follow right along the leading edge.
So now we've actually created a line that takes into account the dimension of the overhang and the backsplash as well as the irregularity in the wall.
Right, so I only have to make one cut. Now, the countertop fits tight against the back wall now. It was pretty straight.
So we don't have to scribe there.
Right. So what I want to do is I want to slide the countertop forward and make a gap for that backsplash to drop into.
Okay, it's
in. All right, now we push the countertop back tight to the wall, and I want to make sure that I'm on my scribe line here. Okay, it's right there. We're tight against the back. Now I want to cut the countertop to allow for the overhang from the face of the cabinet to the front edge of the countertop.
And what's your overhang going to be?
It's going to be an inch across the front here and across the front here.
Okay.
So I set my scribes at an inch and I simply mark right across the face of the cabinet. Now I just connect the marks and make the cuts. All right, let's see how it fits. Right up against the backsplash.
Right.
That's
here.
Good. Okay. Now I cut a piece to finish up this end over here. Okay, everything fits good. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to build up this edge. I want to make the countertop look thicker. To do that, rip down some strips of plywood. I'm going to attach it to the underside of the sheet and go all the way around the perimeter with those. Now we get a countertop that's an inch and a quarter thick. We're affixing these plywood strips to the underside of the countertop using quarter-inch crown staples and glue. All right, countertop is all built, and underneath you can see around the perimeter are pieces, and right here is a splicing piece that joins the two pieces together that we needed to add next to our stove.
Okay.
And this piece of laminate right here is 5 feet wide. It's custom ordered.
This is not something they stock at the home center. This
nope.
was a special order, but it makes a lot of sense.
Right, we're not gonna have any seams in that countertop. All right, now you notice when we unrolled that roll, Kevin, we unrolled it slow because it could actually snap and rip.
Okay, so now you're ready to cut, and it's just a rough cut to start?
Right, what we've done is we've overhung the piece in the back about an inch and a quarter.
Yep.
And the same thing on that edge there.
Gotcha.
And now I'll cut it with this trim router. And this is a bearing right here that'll ride against the front edge of the countertop, cutting the laminate with this cutter part right here. Now, I didn't cut it flush on the back here, and I didn't cut it flush on the back over here. And that gives me enough play to work with the sheet. With the remaining piece, we're going to cut some oversized strips for the backsplash and the edges. Now we're ready to start gluing on the laminate, and we're going to start with the edging. And I'm going to use a spray-on contact cement around the perimeter. Now I spray the laminate, and I also have to spray the edging of the countertop too. And when they're both dry to the touch, then it's ready to stick on. To make a nice tight bond between the two surfaces, I'm using a J-roller. Now I'm going to use a laminate trimmer and trim the laminate flush. Now we're going to use a belt sander to true up this edge. We put the edge on first. When we put the top on, it will overlap the front edge.
In addition to a new countertop, we're also getting a new sink, so we've got to cut a hole for that.
Right, I've taken the template for the sink and I've centered it over the cabinet below, and now I'm ready to cut the hole with a jigsaw. Glue the laminate down to the wood countertop using a contact cement, only this time we're going to roll it on. Because this contact cement underneath the laminate and on the countertop, we only get one shot at putting this down.
All right.
So we've laid some dowels on top of the countertop, and that will allow us to position the laminate. We want to have an overhang all the way around, Kevin. So it should be about a half an inch or a quarter of an inch down that end.
Yep.
All right, now just hold it for a second. Let me check it over here. All right, that's good. We've got an overhang all the way around. Now you've got it. Now don't let it move now. I'm going to pull a couple of pieces of dowel out. All right, now I'm going to put it down easy. All right, now I'm going to start sliding the dowels out and working my way down towards you. All right, Kevin, now we're ready to cut the hole off for a sink. Now the edge of the countertop can be pretty sharp. To ease that edge and really smooth it out, I'm simply going to file it off. To seal the edge between the backsplash and the countertop so no water will get down there, we're going to caulk. Now we just screw the backsplash to the counter. You ready? No, don't go in too fast now. There you go. All right, Kevin, I'll pick it up. A few dabs of sealant on the top of the cabinet will hold the counter down.
Okay.
Okay, you ready? All right. Okay. Now we're ready for the sink. To seal the sink to the countertop, we're going to run a bead of caulking around the opening.
Got it?
Yep.
Watch my fingers. Hang on. Come up. And.
All right, and make it straight with the front. You got 1 3/4 there. Now measure the same part of the sink right there. How's that?